What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Proto 2 National Cup. We are almost coming to a close, or at least the tournament is starting to get to that. A little bit late, yes, I know, but for right now we're going to have, well, Finstack, apparently. I didn't realize they changed the name for that. It's pretty much Stark. You guys probably know them as Stark going up against Team Ukraine, and this is, I believe, a slightly different Team Ukraine. They got bumped down to the lower bracket, and that's where we are right now, by the Russians, and that was, yeah, definitely... at least to some extent, a little bit of a different squad. Had RTs and Bignum in there. But for the most part, I mean, White Pippo is still here. I think Dodgers was playing there as well. Should be capable enough at least to make this an interesting game. And, of course, Finstack, a.k.a. Stark, no slouches in their own right. I'm Mike Loris, going to be your caster for today. But yeah, we are almost getting there. Team Turkey and Russia have to play in the winner's bracket finals. We have a couple more, one, two... three, including this one extra game, so like four-ish more games before we're done with this tournament, and it has been quite a ride. Not really the fault of anyone, just like this tournament is hard to schedule because, you know, Stark are one of the only few teams, few remaining teams at least, that are actually a real team, so they actually all play together and they have a very similar schedule. Everyone else, I mean, getting five people from usually five different teams to agree on a time and place to play, it's very, very difficult, and that's just the side effect of a tournament like this. 10 seconds remaining. You can't really blame the players, you can't really blame the management or the admins or anything like that. 5 seconds that's just how it goes, but either way, we'll see what we are looking at as far as the draft Radiant is concerned. Invoker Doom gonna be banned out. Got Tuskbane as well now. Okay, well, it is going to leave the IO in, but I was about to say that I have seen Stark perhaps a little bit more so than other teams, at least in the Euro CIS scene, experiment a little bit more with what they can get away with. I believe I did see them run, I don't really remember who it was, but it was one of those kind of weirder heroes in the jungle, one of those weirder melee heroes, Iron Talon, whatnot. And I like teams that are trying to experiment with those types of strats, so it doesn't seem like that's going to be super likely right now. Grabbing an IO already usually weakens your side lanes. You don't really want to have a jungler on top of that. That's going a little bit too greedy. But yeah, it is possible to see that maybe in game two. This is best of three, by the way, in case I didn't mention that. But for Team Ukraine, they're going to grab the Gyrocopter because it's Gyrocopter Disruptor immediate response to the IO. A decent start here. Not going to slam first pick the Tiny. Try to pseudo ban that one away from Team Finland. And I wouldn't really be super surprised to see it picked up right now. Does a decent job versus the Gyrocopter, of course. But, you know, for the most part, it's just IO Tiny. And now you have your mid lane all shored up. A little bit of flexibility. You can dip into those side lanes with this duo. But you know, for more likely than not, it's going to be this two-hero setup over in the mid lane. And they should make sure not to get stomped too badly by their mid lane opposition. Not going to be that Viper, not going to be that Invoker, so usually things are pretty clean from there on out. And Team Ukraine, they have the Disruptor, who is really good up against the IO in the mid phase of the game, when IO is going to be looking to bounce around with the Tiny, try to get those kills. 10 seconds. But as far as early stage is concerned, Disruptor doesn't really do that much. You generally want to have just a lot of burst, a lot of lockdown, in order to kill off the IO. And at least kill the IO by the time the Tiny kills off his target. So at the very worst, you make a one-for-one trade. Disruptor doesn't really do that well. Glimpse, not really super useful. Thunderstrike is a pretty high damage spell, granted, but it's not very quick as far as the damage is concerned. It comes out very slowly. 5 seconds. So Disruptor in the early stage, as far as ganking the IO Tiny, not exactly a hero that you really want to have. Reserve time. But it's still not too late for Team Ukraine to grab a nice, solid mid laner. You know, there are many heroes that do perfectly fine versus the IO Tiny, Windranger, Lina, you know, the list goes on and on. Queen of Pain still in the pool, might be banned out here by Team Finland. But aside from that, it's just Team Ukraine having to ban out a couple of the more powerful heroes in those side lanes. Like, what are they worried about? With the Gyrocopter Disruptor, they shouldn't really be worried about too much. They have a lot of teamfight damage coming out from them already. Not to mention some decent responses to the IO Tiny. Gyrocopter is... you know, it is not the best hero up against IO Tiny, like he's not on top of the stack, but it's for sure a hero that is perfectly capable. If you see the little glowy relocate thing, just drop some missiles on it, and as far as carries are concerned, that's a pretty good response. A Tiny and an IO who are very immobile because of the slow from cooldown, not going to be doing that much damage. Now, I have seen Stark, or Finstack, I'm probably going to be calling them both guys, run a Lone Druid before, and I still have not casted a Lone Druid game. Maybe because, like, Lone Druid's getting really big within the Shanghai qualifiers, and I haven't really been casting a ton of that. So maybe that's like why that is, but still, I'm kind of crossing my fingers for it. It will make it that their team is super
Radiant's
bulky, and
team.
for Ukraine, yeah, they have the Gyrocopter, one of the higher damage core heroes you can grab. But as far as the damage coming out from their supports, it's a Rubick, it's a Disruptor. Again, good heroes to have versus the IO Tiny, but as far as controlling them, that's pretty much the extent of it. As far as killing them, Rubick and Disruptor don't really do it that well unless they have a lot of health from their cores. You will be able to just have Rubick and/or Gyrocopter really just
10 seconds
in a dual lane on
remaining.
the top lane and lift up into a Rocket Barrage. Very old
Five
combo. It
seconds
works
remaining.
pretty darn well, depending on what Finland are going to grab. Actually, kind of surprised the Team Ukraine grabbed the dis
Reserve
ban out the
time.
Disruptor. Not the Disruptor, Darkseer. What the hell am I talking about? Because they have the Disruptor. English. So they take out the Darkseer, even though they have a Disruptor. You would think that they would kind of try to dare Team Finland to grab that hero. Because Darkseer works perfectly well with IO Tiny. Vacuum into an Avalanche Toss, not to mention the potential cleave down the line. Yeah, things get really messy if you do have that combo. But then again, Disruptor usually picked up in direct response to the Darkseer, so it would have worked out, I think, a little bit better for Ukraine if they just left that in the pool and banned out any other offlane hero. By the way, Ukraine may suffer from a lack of damage. They have an abundance of control, but the damage department kind of lacking with the Rubick and Disruptor. They really kind of do need a hero like TA or Windranger in order to kind of shore up that damage weakness in their mid lane, at least. Usually, the damage isn't going to be coming from your offlane hero. It is possible to see that.
Dire
But we
team
got an
pick.
Oracle now for Team Stark. So, yeah, this is going to be a difficult game for Ukraine to actually take down this Tiny. First of all, you'll just have to deal with the IO. Second of
Radiant
all,
team pick.
let's look at false prom. You can't see that. Never mind. So I'm gonna
Dropped.
mouse over false promises, and you guys can understand
Dire
what I'm trying
team
to say.
found.
IO and false promises. It's pretty
Radiant
legit. You get
team
the healing
found.
ward mixed in there. Pretty much the Stark special. They do love themselves some Juggernaut, and you have a ton of sustain here from Team Finland. And the downside, of course, is that Oracle and IO, much like how Rubick and Disruptor don't really do a lot of damage, the same can be said for Oracle IO. But the defensive power of Oracle IO
10
is
seconds
so
remaining.
high. And Ukraine are kind of like more in this team fight utility department, which is not necessarily a bad thing, especially with this
Dire team
Puck
pick.
pickup. They will have an immense amount of team fight. But will that team fight be strong enough to kill off the Tiny or the Juggernaut when they have this much sustain behind them? Like, Juggernaut doesn't really have that much to fear right now. Team Ukraine are going to go even harder
Radiant
into the
team
team fight,
pick.
grabbing a Brewmaster. I do like this pick. Finstack only have Avalanche, really, as their way to answer the Brewmaster. No heroes right now, at any rate, going to be grabbing an Orchid or a fast Sheepstick or anything like that. But Brewmaster still, much like Rubick and Disruptor, really, doesn't really do a ton of damage. I'm assuming it's going to be an offlane Puck, in which case that should be
Ten
an okay lane
seconds
for Team
remaining.
Ukraine. The presumed Oracle Juggernaut dual lane there can't really do
Five
too much to shut
seconds
down a
remaining.
Puck, so he should be able to get his experience. But Brewmaster in the mid lane versus IO Tiny, I'm not really convinced that that's going to
Reserve
be the best
time.
lane here for Team Ukraine. Brewmaster, he does have clap and right clicks, but in the mid game, his team fight presence is more so, much like Disruptor and Rubick, kind of the utility-ish angle. His split
Ten
doesn't actually do that
seconds
much damage.
remaining.
He gets value from the split because it makes him pretty much impossible to kill,
Five
usually.
seconds remaining.
But against Juggernaut and Tiny, it's going to be
Nyx
possible,
Assassin.
very possible to kill him off. And then we have a Nyx Assassin last pick here for Stark. Very interesting to see them cap off their draft with a Nyx. It is at the very worst. Oh, am I going to crash again? Please hold. Well, I'm lagging a little bit, but we'll get there. There we go. At the very worst for the Nyx Assassin, it is going to be very difficult for them to kill him off because the Spike Carapace is going to be a pain in the ass for every single one of these Team Ukraine heroes. The Mana Burn, you have an Impale, and yeah, Brewmaster is going to be struggling to deal with that. As far as the 1v1 basis is concerned versus the Nyx, oh god. What is going on? I feel like my mouse sensitivity is always wrong whenever I load in. I don't know why that is. Maybe it's because I change it a little bit without realizing it. That shouldn't be it. Anyway, the Nyx Assassin is going to still have a tough lane. Like, Glimpse doesn't do any damage, so that isn't really a great response. And being able to spike Carapace a Rocket Barrage rocket, whoop-de-frickin'-do. I do assume that Trixie, usually the offlane for Finstack, is going to be going towards offlane and is going to be going up against some sort of Gyrocopter setup. Nick Sasson may be in for a little bit of a tough time here. And again, the puck is going to have a much easier time should he go towards bottom. But who knows where he's actually going to go right now. We're going to have some shuffled lanes here. Aggro tri-lane for Ukraine. Okay, so if this actually is the setup here for Ukraine, I'm not sure if I like it a ton. Oracle's not exactly the best at brawling. Juggernaut is perfectly fine at doing so. And, you know, Gyrocopter is pretty much the best hero at doing that. But Disruptor and Rubick, again, have an abundance of control with not that much damage. They are going to be leaning very hard on their right clicks in order to get these kills. And to a certain degree, that will work out. I guess, you know, you get the Fate's Edict. So it's like, yeah, we don't have any magic damage. We'll just right click them. Fate's Edict, suddenly a dead skill. So there is some value, I suppose, there. But they will have to work a lot with those right clicks. And that is far, far, far from a reliable way of getting those kills. Let's just say there is no... Uh-oh. Okay, Sia spotted. He has another tether to get down. He will do just that. Even getting a shot on his way out. What a piece of shit, this Io. I don't really know. They're trying to, I guess, trap someone with the Tiny. And that's not going to happen, obviously. But yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, leaning on your right clicks is fine, but in an offensive tri-lane capacity, you really want to have some sort of, other source of magical damage. Eventual Spirit or Visage. I mean, those are the heroes that you want in an offensive tri-lane. In a perfect world, of course. Still, Juggernaut with an Oracle helping him is not going to be super strong, especially if Valix does take a very early leave of absence out of this bottom lane. Juggernaut can do absolutely nothing against three ranged heroes, and he's just going to get picked apart nonstop. Taking a look at this mid lane situation, Puck going up against Io Tiny. This is okay for the Puck. Base damage is pretty decent. Trading hands with OK Sia, you can see already going very well for him. But once the bottle's already up, once the Avalanche Toss actually becomes a little bit higher than just level 1, we can see how easy it is for a Tiny and an Io to put almost completely free damage onto a Puck. Yeah, you can phase shift for a little bit, but 0.75 seconds may dodge, like, I don't know how much of the Avalanche, you can dodge a little bit of it, but it's not going to be keeping you super sustained going up against an Io Tiny combo. So, yeah, this Puck is going to have an okay time, but is going to be a very delicate time. I guess it is kind of similar to Nemphy on the bottom lane. He has no backup right now, and he's going to get Glimpse back, or at least they'll try to. He'll spin it off, and he will survive for a little while longer, but 120 mana cost, and that is not a sustainable strategy here for this Juggernaut. He does have a Mango, so he'll be able to do it one more time, and he can probably wait for another 40 mana. So he has a couple more times in the tank, but yeah, for the most part, this Juggernaut is not going to get that much CS. Avalanche will be dodged, kind of, but still, there's a toss there. Right clicks as well. A lot of extra damage on this Puck, and yeah, he will orb himself out, but... Bottle, it's actually empty right now, so Kasha Invoker maybe having a small chance here. There's a toss. If he gets tossed up right now, that will hurt. He has an orb. Avalanche, it's gonna connect. Orb still is live, though, and the Puck will jump out. He'll be fine, but 2-minute rune spawn looks like it's gonna be picked up by the Io, and we can see this Puck is very quickly starting to run out of regeneration. Has fairy fire, but that's not something you really want to eat just for sustain's sake. Oh, Puck is going to once again throw out another orb, slowed down by the tether. Now Boogie has enough mana for an avalanche and a toss. This might be first blood. No, there's just an avalanche. Rubick is going to come in. Boogie lifted into the tower. First blood still drawn by the Tiny, though. Gets a toss off before he dies. Okay, Sia, though, is now taking tower aggro. He's going to get very far away, but not far enough away. A 2-for-1 in favor of Team Ukraine. Now, they do lose their Puck, giving up first blood to the Tiny, I believe, got the last hit. Yes, he did. Tiny draws first blood on the Puck, but taking the Tiny and Io combo down does cost Ukraine rotation from both the Rubick and Disruptor. Having Io sitting in tower range kind of makes it, you don't really need an abundance of damage to get that kill. But it also frees up the Juggernaut to get, at the very least, a little bit of experience on the bottom lane. 2 CS is nothing really to write home about, but hey, it's better than nothing. We see the Brewmaster having a much better time in the meantime towards top lane. This combo of Nick Sasson and Oracle, like, Fortune's End into Impale, I guess, is kind of a combo. But you need a lot of extra damage on top of that if you're going to be getting those kills. Avalanche Toss, how much damage is this going to do? About half to the Puck. With a full bottle, they could run that back very quickly. But yeah, the Brewmaster doesn't really have that much to fear. It's an annoying lane for sure. But once the Nyx Assassin's tapped out of mana, like, he can eat his mangoes, I guess, but really doesn't want to. Arcane Boots, probably not going to be coming up for quite a long time, although he gets a little bit too far out, gets stopped up, and now the Impale's there. Mana Burn, not quite going to do Purifying Flames, right clicks, just enough damage. The Rubick's going to arrive, drops Trixie into the creep wave, but this is a Nyx Assassin we're talking about here. Nyx Assassin with a Stout Shield. turning around with the Orb of Venom, even. I didn't realize he had that. I mean, I saw it, but it didn't register. Oh, Asteroid? Is he in trouble still? Purifying Flames. He has two of them. Is that enough? He's trying to go deep onto the Nyx Assassin. We'll right-click. Gonna grab the kill. And Purifying Flames actually gonna heal. Whoa, okay, that never mind. Just enough damage to get it with the second cast. Dodgers is coming in pretty quickly. Velix trying to juke out. I think there was an angle for a clap there, but either way, Velix should live. A one-for-one trade, a decent trade again, and over towards mid again. Such a delicate situation over in mid. It's really only a matter of time before the puck gets picked off, since Boogie's Avalanche cast range, just high enough to pressure the puck. 4-3, and for Finstack, they aren't really dealing with this Gyrocopter that well. Getting a hell of a lot of farm. In fact, Nemphy now going to get Thunderstruck up. That is an arcane Thunderstrike as well. Spin, once again, going to be forced to dodge that Glimpse. But still, this Gyrocopter is last hitting to his heart's content, and there really will be nothing that Team Star can actually do about this. Boogie going to go in deep, a little bit too deep perhaps. Bottle check, there is one bottle charge. Sticks as well. Boogie taking tower shots, but it looks like the damage not quite high enough. Now, Ukraine are actually playing around, or, you know, I'm not sure how intentional it is, but again, the lack of damage, raw damage output from the heroes is kind of being mitigated by the fact that these heroes, oh, Fortune's End, it's going to stop White Pippo dead in his tracks. His rune runs out. Asteroid's going to come around, but he gets crit down and then purified by Velix. And the creeps are here even, so these split damage from the Gyrocopter's not doing a ton. The Gyrocopter will slip away to the side. Velix, in the meantime, will drive out Asteroid, but Nemphy, does he still want to fight this? They know that Gyrocopter's salving up. Rocket Barrage is a lot of damage. Nemphy might have bitten off a little bit more than he could chew. Stop is there. Is the Juggernaut fast enough? He's going to chug down a salve of his own, and it's going to be canceled this time. Asteroid going to come out from the side. Has Arc Boots. He has a Fade Bolt there for Velix. Isn't going to die to it, but a lift up and a glimpse back. Where is he going to end up? A little bit off to the left. The sustain from the Oracles. Just enough with the healing ore. In fact, Nemphy and Velix both looking like they're going to live. No! The downtown shot from this Black Cannon is going to get the kill, but now Boogie has arrived. He has 8 stick charges. However, nothing is available. He has another toss. That should get the kill on the Gyrocopter, and it will. Double kill for Boogie, and do they still know where White Pippo is? Yes, because there's a random range creep here for some reason. Boogie's going to charge right in with OKC. A 1 stick charge. Is that going to be enough for a toss? Toss up. Right clicks. They got him. I was going to grab that kill. 8-4 in favor of Team Stark, Team Finstack. In the meantime, top lane, Trixie. Well, he was able to force out the Brewmaster ultimate. I don't think this was supposed to be an offensive move, but they're going to make it into one. Asteroid's kind of stuck in the trees. Can't quite find the range to land any spells onto Trixie right now. And he's taking tower shots. He's very, very soft. Look, Trixie is going to be in down eventually. Dodges. He's aggro pulled off by someone. Potion Poker will grab it. The Rubik was actually burned down by the Oracle. Intercepted him, so yeah, didn't see that one. But you guys can use your imagination. Purifying Flames does do some pretty decent damage in a one-shot blast. 9-5 and Finstack, they aren't really making the best trades in the world necessarily. Like over in mid, a 2-for-1. Over down towards the bottom lane, I don't really know the overall numerical trades, but Ukraine are pretty much giving away supports more often than not, and Finstack are giving away their cores. Trixie, though, can impale and Purifying Flames in the Brewmaster. Whoo, baby. It's a lot of damage. The Flames don't have a long cooldown, 2.25 seconds. Dire's middle tower. And it seems like the burst damage is just enough to kill off this Brewmaster. I would have thought that Brewmaster would be able to survive that more often than not, but it seems like this is going to be, what, his second death? Yeah. And Trixie is now going to have some extra mana. There we go. Arc Boots making this lane so much easier for him, pretty much by himself. Velix now going to join Nemphy. Level 3 spin. Here comes the stop. They will not get the spin off, unfortunately. Nemphy is going to get lifted up beforehand. But it doesn't really cost them much, just one Fortune's End. Who cares? 10-5, and still Boogie's having a grand old time. Power Treads, level 7, 1300 gold. Blink Dagger is just a stone's throw away. No pun intended for this tiny. Call down onto Velix. Out of the blue, he is going to defend himself against all this magic damage from the Gyrocopter, and Nemphy's going to come around from the side. Now False Promise into Velix. He might pop to this, but still they're at least going to get Asteroid in exchange. White Pippo is going to arrive. Glimpse back, okay, see ya. So he can't die right now. Nemphy's going to grind down the Rubik. Still does not have level 6. He's going to be cut off by the Gyrocopter. Velix has something to say about this, I think. Maybe? No, he can't quite get in range for the Edict. And the Gyrocopter will eventually pick off the Juggernaut. And again, this is what I'm talking about. These numerical trades are kind of going okay for Finstack, but as far as who they're trading away for what, a Juggernaut dying for a Rubik, that's not a trade you ever really want to be making. That's why we see kind of the middle of the pack as far as farm is concerned, all a big chunk of green. Yeah, the Tiny's having a great time for sure, but everyone else, they're getting kills at the expense of their own life. And this Gyrocopter is, you know, brawling a little bit more than perhaps Finstack are really prepared for. if Nemphy had the Omni Slash, maybe they could have gotten away with that super aggressive Rubick play, but obviously that wasn't really the case. Boogie, OKC is stalked by a Puck, who does have a coil. Dodger's gonna come in from the side, has a clap. OKC is only gonna get caught by the coil, but still they should have enough damage to kill out this IO pretty easily, and they do. They will still split with the Brewmaster, chuck a rock at Boogie. I think he like might have been better off canceling that, because now he doesn't have it, and like that just means that defensively he's not really there. Valix, Fortune's End, it's not being charged up there just yet. There it is onto Pippo, but now Dodgers is the target. Purifying Flames needs another one, not quite in range. Oh no, it is in range. Trixie's even coming from the side. Mana Burn up White Pippo. Valix is gonna take a fall here, but Boogie's now gonna get close enough to at least think about joining the action. Avalanche Toss is not gonna be casted. It will, but you know, kind of late. He gets glimpsed back. A one-for-one trade, this one a little bit better for the Finstack. 12-8, and Boogie, he's surviving. 4-1-1 on the Tiny. And we have relocation down towards the bottom lane. Gyrocopter's already on the run. There is no mana for the Omni Slash. OKC gets chucked right in front of him, and body blocks enough for the spin. Well played by the IO. I thought he was going to try to just angle a tether for the marginal amount of slow there. That would have probably done it as well, but yeah, no Omni Slash needed. Get the kill anyway. OKC's relocation now up. Tiny's Blink Dagger now up. And let's take a look at Trixie's status. He's level 8. And yeah, you can get Blink Dagger, Force Staff, and Assassin. Those are all great items to have, but really, it's all about those levels and all about not dying also. He's going to immediately Vendetta. Looks like there is backup incoming for him. He doesn't have a ton of mana, but he will have Arcane Boots and a Mango to eat if he so desires. Arcane Boots even on Valix, so I don't really know what that edict's about. Okay, there's the Flames. Can they go for Dodgers here? They know he doesn't have his ultimate. Of course, Asteroid is the much softer target, but they also know that he has Spike Carapace. So though he is technically softer, he may be more difficult to kill if you return and impale. Oh, he's going to try to teleport out of here, though. That's not going to happen. In the meantime, they lose the Disruptor, but Trixie's going to solo the Rubick. Now the missiles are going to fall down only onto the Nyx Assassin, however, and Dodgers, I don't think, has enough to kill off Valix by himself. Trixie's going to Spike Carapace, TP away. Valix should also be okay over in the mid lane. In the meantime, Posh Invoker are going to chase down by the IO Tiny combo. More Avalanche is available. That should be enough damage. Yes, it will, but Puck, no, is actually going to jump down to the low ground. I thought he died. He's going to grab a double kill and barely escapes with his life. Oh my god. Well, that was a little bit close for this Puck, and again, the numerical trade is not really great for Finstack. Valix is going to edict himself. Purifying Flame is going to be charged in offensively towards Pippo, but the Puck is going to come in. One more orb through. Valix is going to burst them down, though, with one Flames. He needs some help, though. Is the promise going to be false or true? Oh, it's false. Yes, that is what false promises really means, guys, and that is, you know, me dropping some serious knowledge there. White Pippo, though, is going to get Vendetta to the Dome. Relocate coming in. I think it's just the Isle, but with right-clicks and the Spirits, can they just get this kill? Impale is available now. I don't think they need it to land. I think the Spirit should be able to get it. There we go. Okay, see ya. He's gonna grab that kill. Yank Trixie back to the fountain. Yep, all the way back. 17 to 11, and this is a game. This is a game for sure. Omni Slash into Asteroid. Wow, it looked like he actually spun mid Omni Slash. He can't do that, but I don't know. Maybe I have lag. That was pretty sick, though. That was pretty sick. If you could spin during Omni Slash, that would be cool. Now the Puck after that double kill is going to have a grand old time. Yeah, he did kind of suicide away to Valix. Going to dodge the Fortune's End, so that's going to keep the heal sustained through. But okay, Brewmaster grenade instigibs. The Posh Invoker is very close to his Blink Dagger, and I don't really think that Nemphy can do much about it. He has an Ace Rune though, so he's damn sure going to try. Backup from Ukraine is coming in spades. Fortune's End again going to be thrown. Spin is there. Posh Invoker should not die ever to this combo, especially with backup coming. Drop a two-man coil. Nemphy now does not have his spin. They went a little bit too deep. Healing Ward is going to be deployed. Valix, is he going to survive? Because Valix has been playing pretty darn well. He's going to put the promise on himself. But once again, this is not going to do it. Actually, it wasn't the promise. That was the edict. My bad. But Ukraine traded another two-for-one exchange. And again, another great two-for-one. Juggernaut and Oracle really should not be able to kill off a Puck. And clearly we see it's not enough. TP coming in. Someone has travels. That's... no. Okay, never mind. It looked like it was Finstack's travels, but it was just Brewmaster teleporting on a creep. I may be tripping balls, guys. That is a very high possibility. Ooh, Trixie, he's got Aether Lens. He disassembled his Arcane Boots for that, and now he's got eyes on Dodgers. Blink forward, Avalanche needs a toss. He's gonna toss up the Nyx Assassin. There's way too many heroes here, though. Static Storm onto three, and they're all gonna die. Tiny's up in the air. He'll fall into missiles. Ukraine, five-manning super early, and again, this is where their team fight comes into play. And well, for one thing, Finstack did not expect that many heroes to be there. Once you get with the Static Storm, it is pretty much all over. If the Avalanche toss Dodgers, properly. Maybe they could have gotten away with it, but we could see the vision for the Radiant side. Not exactly conducive to seeing what's going down in this Roshan pit kind of area. They were just caught blind. And that is also the Puck Blink Dagger revealed, but also Dodger is getting very close to his own Blink Dagger. Finstack, yeah, they do still have a Tiny with Blink. Juggernaut, though, maybe playing things a little bit too aggressively down in the bottom lane. Ukraine are doing still really well for themselves. Blink Daggers, double Blink Daggers, in fact. Gyrocopter still happily farming. We look up towards top lane with Trixie already setting things up. There's the Vendetta Gank, Avalanche Toss. Oh my god, that's such a brutal combo. Such a classic IO combo as well. Like, not only just IO Tiny, because they can do that with anyone, but having a Nyx Assassin as the person to kind of spot out those ganks, he did a lot of damage there, and no one's really going to deny that, but at the bare minimum, Trixie and Vendetta is just a great scout. Like, Bounty Hunter also is another hero that we see a little bit more often mixed into that combo. You just scout out for those targets, and Gyrocopter is pretty tough to take down. He's got Helm, we have Quila Sticks. He's not going for, like, a super glass cannon build or anything like that. No Yasha first. But still, yeah, find your target, relocate on him, and if you don't miss the Impale, you're guaranteed that kill almost every single time. That didn't work. Bottom lane, Nemphy. Asteroid's gonna lift him up. He does have a spin. They're gonna get the Static Storm, but he slips into the trees away from the Static Storm. Now he's gonna straight TP out. That's a little bit awkward. Nemphy, he's gonna survive. So close to being perfect. Not quite there. They had double damage on Dodgers. If they were able to get him in the Static Storm, Juggernaut doesn't stand a chance. They'll take down the tower. I'm sure that's fine for them. TP up towards top lane. It's the Puck. He is going to orb out. That is a pretty nice window now for Stark to go in for this. However, they are working, again, completely blind. They've lost the tower. Looking to make a one-for-one tower trade right now. They have four heroes here, but they have put a lot of stock into Boogie and Nemphy in order to win this game for them. Just by picking up the Io and Oracle. It's, again, inherently defensive, kind of babysitting-oriented heroes. But these... if this duo Tiny and Juggernaut keep falling, then they'll find themselves in a rough spot. Ukraine, they have all of their ultimates up, almost. Disruptor is lacking here, but Dodgers has the double damage rune. He's ready to go in. Boogie, in fact, can take a lot of damage. Two-man Coil is there. Immediately, Valix is going to start bailing him out with False Promises. However, it's not going to stop the Coil from snapping. And they go in and assassinate the Io. At least Dodgers with the double damage rune. Glimpse back onto someone. It's Boogie. He needs help right now, but I don't think there's enough heroes in the world that could save him. That's a 2-kill for Ukraine. And the thing that Finstack should be looking to dodge, more so than anything else, is the 5-on-5. They kind of walked straight into that. Did they even kill off the tower? No, they didn't even get the tower. Posh Invoker is able to grab the last hit from there. And it is Finstack kind of to fall apart. One too many poor trades giving Ukraine these Blink Daggers, and that is just so much extra to grind through. The scary thing is that Ukraine now Static Storm up. They still have Split up. They didn't use that before. It's going to be tower down, continuing this push up towards top. Ukraine, as long as they have the split, are going to be willing to do this. But for Finstack, this is really where they have to kick into gear, split pushing and whatnot. Nymphy doesn't really have a lot as far as the farm is concerned, so his split push rate is very, very slow. Finstack defending this kind of involves getting a cheesy initiation, kind of pickoff onto the disruptor or someone like that. But again, as long as Ukraine are in a full 5-on-5, then I don't really see Stark losing this. Stark winning this, rather. Throw a catapult on him, that'll show him. Impale, Mana Burn. Doesn't do jack, because Brewmaster's not the brightest cookie in the jar. Trixie's gonna get glimpsed back into a Static Storm. He is gonna get interrupted out of it with a Coil. That's one kill. And also, well, Io is here as well. That's another. There's an Avalanche onto the Puck, but Tiny, he's gonna get chased down. Should be fine. Brewmaster. Dude. Brewmaster, he's going in, man. I don't know where he's going to teleport into the trees. No, he's just going to walk out. There's no one incoming for Finstack, so sure, go ahead and dive the tier 3s. You might as well. Oh, okay, never mind. You probably shouldn't do that. Did not expect that to happen. Boogie's going to find and assassinate the Brewmaster. Pasha should be fine. And Astro up towards top lane is going to get purified. It is the duo of, once again, Nemphy and Valix. Grab that kill, glimpse back onto the Oracle. He is going to run off to the side, has False Promises, and Nemphy has an Omni Slash. White Pippo is going to take that all to his face. That's an immediate kill, and the Oracle is home free. I don't think Nemphy's going to die here. He's just going to teleport out. There's no interrupts. That's overall a 3-kill for Finstack, but it does cost them like a 3 or 4 deaths beforehand, so ultimately, I think numerically at least, Ukraine still is going to be in the lead as far as the kills are concerned. Finstack do still have Aghanim Scepter coming up on Boogie. In fact, just a couple more seconds and you'll have that. So that's kind of nice. Double Aetherlens. The Assassin's still scouting out for these assassination plays. And should be coming in about 10 seconds. I don't really think they can get the puck. It's going to be really hard to kill the puck with that. But, ooh, they can see the stack. And they literally just pick up the Aghanim Scepter. So now's the time to steal stack. Oh, Gyrocopter. You don't want to be here, bro. He's going to get... ooh. I think the ancients and the neutrals share vision, so I think Ukraine should know that this is warded, because usually you don't get aggroed by that. But up towards top, in the meantime, Dodger's gonna get blinked in. Avalanche toss, dead Brewmaster. Very well executed gank there. Forced TP out from the puck. Looking at Valix right now. He has a coil, but do you really want to spend it on just an Oracle? Seems like the answer is a definite maybe. Glimpse is not quite in range. If you coiled him and glimpsed him, you could have snapped it and gotten the kill. I'm not really sure if that's worth it. In the meantime, Trixie's still playing some games here, looking for Asteroid right now. They see Nemphy incoming, however, Impale, Mana Burn, Asteroid pretty much dead already. Nemphy's gonna tap him with the Blade Fury. Avalanche toss now into the Gyrocopter, he's gonna lay the call down. And that's gonna do some serious damage, but with the Healing Ward, it's not really gonna be permanent damage. Ukraine still are coming in, have a Static Storm, Brewmaster's gonna be up soon. Stealing a stack, though, looking very appealing, gonna be risky. Oh, they blink right into an Impale, though. Trixie's gonna land a two-man. Avalanche isn't there, but the toss is gonna kill off the puck, or at least drop him very low. He drops the coil beforehand, but still is gonna get chased down. One more Avalanche is all they need. Don't miss it, Boogie. Well, it's gonna be dodged, so I guess you can count that as a miss. Blink away from the puck, and he's gonna live. Dodges, however, may not be as lucky. He does have this... the split, and it's not going to get stunned out beforehand. He's now going to gun towards Nemphy. He's going to try to pick off the puck in the sidelines, cycling up into the air. He has a spin as soon as he falls, and he has backup incoming. Avalanche on a toss onto the Gyrocopter. Nemphy's still going to fall, yes, but it's probably worth it here for Team Finstack. Posh Invoker is going to survive off to the side. Boogie not really dropping super fast right now. Now get the False Promises, healed up by the Oracle, gets a toss onto the Brewmaster, just going to stand and fight him. Valix, in the meantime, chasing after Pasha, is going to grab that kill, and oh, they'll grab another one with the Brewmaster. Purifying Flames has been doing so much work over the course of this game, and Boogie has another blink. Does he know where the Rubik is? Boogie, trust your instincts. I'm not really sure if he's going for the Rubik here or what, but I don't think they know the Asteroid's there. Someone's pinging. He's fine. The Rubik's fine, guys. But overall, that fight was absolutely amazing for the Finstack. About that amazing. And to add insult to injury, they're going to be going in for just a little bit more. 1, 2, 3, 4 stack of Ancients. And Ukraine will have absolutely no response to this. That was a very, very scrappy fight. Having Juggernaut kind of isolated away. Having Boogie dropping super low. Yet as long as these supporters, these healers in the back lines are not being pressured, you're kind of allowed to have Tiny and Juggernaut go ham like that. Because, you know, if they get in trouble, just promise them and then start healing up with Purifying Flames. Tether bottled them. Ukraine really have to get to the back lines. And Ukraine as a team kind of filtered in one at a time there. They still are pretty powerful individually. Brewmaster is pretty high level. Gyrocopter is pretty big. But that wasn't really a full 5-on-5 fight. That was like several 1v1s. And that's what Finstack are all about. Trixie gonna find the Brewmaster. He's gonna impale him out of the blue, just to cancel that Blink Dagger, Mana Burn. Here comes the Avatoss. And they're going for stun duration right now. They have to toss him. Boogie, why are you holding it so long? Dodger has a split now, and he's gonna get it off. Boogie is so greedy. And now he just might go down right now. They have to keep this IO alive. They'll relocate out. Trixie will not have that luxury. He gets an impale, but he's gonna get thrown sky high. You just avalanche toss him and he dies, right? He was trying to go for like full on stun duration, but that didn't happen. And Brewmaster, oh, well, he bought out, actually. He didn't lose that much gold. But still, probably shouldn't have died there, because now he doesn't get Roshan experience. It's clear as frickin' day what's going on here. You're kind of going for Roshan. It's not super quick, either. The right-click damage is almost entirely in the department of this Gyrocopter. And in the meantime, top lane's being pushed. Boogie has Aghanim Scepter, and he has level 4 overcharge. So his push rate is serious. So Ukraine, they are taking their sweet time. In fact, Nemphy's going to arrive in. He has a spin. This is pretty greedy. He's going to get glimpsed out, lifted up, everything in the book. He's going to spin to dodge the glimpse away. Forces out a call down. Still, the push is going up towards top lane. Gyrocopter, yes, is going to grab this Aegis, but he doesn't have a TP to get back. So it's going to take him a little while. In the meantime, they've cracked the tier 3s. They're going for range racks. One TP is coming back. Fortification there as well. Dodges does not have a split. He's going to immediately avalanche toss and stop. Purifying Flames is enough damage. It is. Pasha Invoker is going to arrive, but he does not have a coil. He's going to try to assassin OKC with the Dagon. He's not going to have quite enough damage, however. Fade Bolt going to bounce through, but I think with the Flames and the Urn Charge, Io should survive. He's going to jump all the way back to the fountain. Yeah, almost a full restore. Oh my god. Now, Ukraine have gotten the Aegis. They've defended their range racks, but that was costly, man. That was extremely, extremely slow, and Finstack, they're not looking to stop right now as long as this Impale lands. Oh, Puck, that was luck, actually. There's no way that he saw that one coming. He's going to survive. But Finstack are striking back very, very hard. I gotta say, freaking Valix's Oracle. Oh, they're gonna assassinate Asteroid. I did not see that, guys. My bad. Boogie, now the BKB active. Doesn't really have that much to fear. I'm gonna predict that he's probably just gonna end up using it to dodge a glimpse, but he's actually gonna run into White Pippo, toss him up. Nemphy's going to arrive now with an Omni Slash at the ready. There's so much sustain here. They have to kill off this Healing Ward. This Healing Ward in Io is ridiculous. Healing Ward of False Promises even more so. Three-man coil, three-man call down. Okay, see ya. He's dropping very low, but he's not gonna die just yet. No, he will get picked off in the end by the Fly Can, I believe. Boogie now can pop the BKB with a two-man impale from the back lines. Those grab the Aegis and the Gyrocopter and send a Pasha Invoker with a Spike Carapace to the right click damage. Oh, it's not quite gonna be enough. They need just a couple more hits. They toss up the Gyrocopter. They have another Avalanche. Impale, there's no mana for it. Nemphy doesn't have anything either. But they've taken down the range racks. Is that good enough? TP coming in, buyback from the Brewmaster. Nemphy, again, has spin. He's going to use it to get rid of that slow. Trixie's going to get slowed down by just a hair, but he has a Spike Carapace and travels. He should be able to get out of here. Yeah, he's fine. 33-24, the casualty is range racks this time. And probably more crucially, I don't know, than that is the fact that for Finstack, they lose the Io, they lose the Oracle. And to Team Ukraine's credit, that was the game plan. That's what they're supposed to be doing. Oh, they're going to jump in for Nemphy, but the Healing Ward is keeping him alive. And now Boogie's going to come with double damage. Oh, my God. Nice seeing you, Puck. I think that one is probably going to be a home run. So, you know, another point there for Finstack. But, yeah, as I was saying, probably the... Oh, no, we're not done yet. I can't make that point. Trixie is going to get spotted out. Double Vendettas across the map. Vendetta's actually really great to have on Rubick, because the attack range is high on Rubick, naturally, like 600, so you can attack from very far away, then immediately lift them up, so it's you know, pretty much better than Assassins, actually. But as I was saying, they lost the Io and the Oracle, and for Team Ukraine, that's like step one. You kill those two heroes off, then you're allowed to kill off the Juggernaut and the Tiny, at least a lot easier. But they didn't kill them off. Like, Juggernaut survives, now he's that much closer towards his Mantis style. What do we have here? We have a Vlad's, looks like, getting built up by the Io. Almost completed, in fact, just needs a recipe. And Boogie, of course, 13-4-6, just going ham. Speaking of going ham, he's going to go right into White Pippo, beat him down. Nice Glimmer Cape, bro. Does nothing for you. The Disruptor being down with no buyback means that there's no Static Storm, means they can probably just go in. And Boogie's not really getting that much help. Yeah, Overcharge will be nice here. Asteroid's going to jump in, lift him up. I don't think Boogie cares. Jump in from Dodgers. BKB, though, is up, and Boogie's going to beat down the Raxes. They will find Trixie, but the False Promise is going to bail him out. And with all the heal, I'm pretty sure this is a full restore back for the Nyx Assassin once this False Promise ends. Yeah, look at that full heal. Seems fair and balanced. Trixie's still kicking in this fight, as Brewmaster's ultimate is kind of just being wasted right now. He's not doing any damage. And now the Omni Slash and the Toss onto the Rubick and the Puck both. They're both down. Dodge is going to get Avalanche as soon as he goes back to his Earth form. And that's going to be a 4-0. Finstack crushed through Team Ukraine. Oh my god, that was dirty. Parents, divert your children's eyes. It's probably a little bit too late for that, so you have to send them to therapy now. Sorry for not warning you sooner. But again, False Promises, Valix, I guess that time, cutting it a little bit close. That was a little bit close. It was like 20 HP on the Nyx Assassin. But hey, it's good enough, man. It's good enough. So yeah, Trixie's been doing some serious work in this game, but I do think the MVP in this game was Valix. Like, he has 10 freaking kills. Like, there is that. The False Promises have been on point. The Purifying Flames, Fortune's End, it's all been pretty much picture perfect. Keeping Boogie and Nemphy alive, that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. And now Boogie has Moon Shards, so he doesn't really need the help of Overcharge to single siege these towers. That's one down. Roshan timer, not quite up yet. So there's still a lot of time for Finstack to kind of just sit back and chill. Maybe get Aghanim Scepter on the Nyx Assassin. What do we have here? We got the completed Vlads, we have Blink Dagger on the Nyx, actually, so that's pretty good as well. But it's time to take the last tower. Now, Ukraine can still defend this. Their team fight, assuming they have all their ultimates, and they will, is still strong enough that they can just kill off the Finstack without taking too many casualties, assuming OKC and Velix are going to get conned out as well. And they kill off the Healing Ward. But it seems like they're not going to risk it to defend the Tier 2s, simply not worth. It's going to be yet another bag of cash into the gold pot of Finstack, skyrocketing up to a 14k lead. Oh my god. Well, this is going to be hard, but at least for Ukraine, oh, they're actually going to wrap around. Boogie's going to actually bypass that fight. Snatch will completely botch. However, they will do a lot of damage to this Juggernaut. He's going to Omni Slash, buy himself a little bit more time, and he will not die just yet. Just in the meantime, he's going to get False Promise out. OKC and Velix are off in the corner. The Tiny does not have his BKB up, so he's going to get put into the air. Nemphy is just going to die right up to the puck. OKC is going to blink out of the trees with the relocate, but now Boogie, he has a couple of targets, but he just can't quite get on top of them. He finds it finally. He's going to beat down the Gyrocopter, grab that one, do a lot of damage to this puck. He has help from here from Trixie, Mana Burn, Passion Vulgar is just enough to get out of there, but Boogie's going to follow. Beyond Godlike Spree here on the Tiny. Toss now picked up by Astro, but it's going to be a 3-for-3 exchange. Boogie's going to toss Trixie up to clear the trees. That was pretty cute. That was like, well, first of all, like, Miss Static Storm, there's that. So, you know, less than ideal for Ukraine not to have all their pieces of the puzzle there when they need them to, but that was a Tiny who actually just bypassed the entirety of Ukraine by sheer coincidence by blinking into this neutral camp while Ukraine were like over here and over here. So Tiny had no idea what was going on. Yet still, even with Tiny doing like zero damage in that fight, Finstack are healthy enough with all their sustain to just keep on going forward and at least stall out for Tiny to eventually get into a position where he can do some damage. And man, can he do damage. He's got the Moon Shards. He's going to go for a Demon Edge item. He probably is going to go for an MKB here. Got to get MKB up against Brewmaster, guys. Don't forget, Drunken Hay is OP as hell up against Tiny. 41-27, and Ukraine, that wasn't convincing enough for them to really, really have a good chance, fighting chance in this the upcoming minutes of the game. At least not good enough to try to contest Roshan, and that should be the next objective here for the Finstack. Unless they just find a pickoff, in which case they could probably just straight up push and win the game. But yeah, I don't really know if that's going to happen. They are trying for it though. I mean, this is a little bit aggressive. I think giving Boogie time to farm MKB to kind of nullify that mischance is definitely better. As you can see, he can siege doing a lot of damage. The overcharge especially. Oh, Astro's going to blink right into an impale. No! Oh, poor Rubick. What? I don't know what that impale was. I think that was just a read from Trixie. That might have been a read. That might have been luck. I don't know what it was, but man, was it amazing. Now they can get... Now that was their pickoff, man. They can just keep on going. So there you go. Trixie with the mind reads. Oh, there's the toss. Avalanche. Well, not going to happen just time, but the Omni Slash doesn't care about your BKB. They'll take down the Gyrocopter, who also has no buyback. I think that might be game. They're going to dust up, see nothing. They still have a couple of teamfight ultimates. They'll land a two-man Static Storm, but they both have BKBs up, or at least Magic Immunity up. Just in the meantime, occupying Pasha and White People just by himself. He's going to get glimpsed out of there. Blinks out, in fact. And still, Ukraine have no damage right now. Their Brewmaster's running wild, but he's not doing anything with it. Trixie's going to land right into Pasha Invoker, and he's going to turn around and start killing off this puck. Fortune's then going to come in, be dodged. But to what end? White People's going to teleport in immediately into an impale. They also pick off the Brew. And that's GV, apparently, not GG. But Finstack looking a little bit shaky, yet coming together in their team fights, or coming together in their post-team fight plays. Like, those team fights were still not good for the Finstack. Stark were really struggling to deal with the huge 5-on-5 up against Ukraine. It should be the same password, White People. The password is Hunter2, guys. It was the plays in between those fights that made it for Finstack. I think it was the fact that Oracle ended the game 11-6-8. Big MVP there for Velix. Trixie also doing some serious work as the Nyxassassin. Like, it was pretty much those handful of relocate ganks. Get a couple of those. Get the Tiny, his Blink Dagger, and then his BKB, his Aghanim Scepter, whatnot. Get Juggernaut a little bit of extra time to farm up. He doesn't really have a ton of farm, but man, he has enough with all the sustain. And for Ukraine, they really need to take more of those 5-on-5 team fights, because we saw how successful those were. They were really, really good and hard for Finstack to deal with. But unfortunately, it's a little bit too late for that. Guys, I'm Mike Loris. It's been a pleasure casting this game for you. I'll be right back with Game 2 between Team Ukraine and Finstack, or Stark, or whatever you want to call them, in just a little bit.